No, sir. She hates to be
Miss
disturbed.
Punnett, Miss Punnett! Miss Punnett! Is that no. you, Miss Punnett?
Hello? Yes?
It is you, Miss Punnett. What on earth are you doing here?
Just giving your bedroom a bit of a tidy, sir.
At this time of night?
I'm afraid I was delayed. But better late than never, sir, as they say. I know how you like your bedroom to be nice and inviting when you're giving one of your parties.
When did you come?
Just a few minutes ago, sir. I don't like to disturb you, so I came on up here. But I can't seem to find the light. It's as dark as Newgate's Knocker. Are you playing one of your kinky games, Mr. Miller?
I assure you it's just a fuse. It's dark all over the house.
Oh, a fuse! I thought it might be one of those kinky games in the dark, sir. Perhaps the one with the rubber underclothes and the little whips.
Just a fuse, Miss Bonnet. The man is actually mending it now, so the light should be on any minute.
That'll be a relief for you, won't it?
Yes, it would. Why don't you just go on home now, since there's nothing left for you to do here.
Are you sure of that, sir?
It seems rather pointless, doesn't it?
Oh, no, sir. I can clean this place with my eyes shut. And I'd like to, really. I hate your guests see how it usually is. Drawers and panties in the sink. Contraceptives on the floor. Marriage? Guana seeds. Simply everywhere.
Please watch what you say. You may not know it, but you're in front of Mr. Miller's fiancé.
Fiancé?
And I am her father.
Well, sir, I never. May I kiss you, sir, please?
Yes, certainly, of course.
Oh, miss, I'm so happy for you, too. Thank you. And for you, sir. You must be